four Virginia tuners have actually tuned a rider to the winner's spot on a podium at a national event, or one who has carried the number one plate for at least a year. When you think about what the odds are for a tuner to get the number one plate out of all 1,000 people, as well as the factories chasing it, it's fantastic, and we have one here in our midst tonight. I recently read about St. Francis of Assisi. He stated that a man that works with his hands is a laborer. A man that works with his hands and his head is a craftsman, and a man that works with his hands, head, and heart is an artist. These next four men are just that, truly artists. At this time, I'd like to ask Eddie Adkins, John Gould, Roger McGinnis, and Clayton Oliver to come on up here. Four guys who would rather not be here, I could have done a better job. They produce with their hands and their hearts, not their mouths, but maybe we can pry a few words out of them. You'll note that I call them by alphabet. I don't want a black eye. Let's start with Eddie Adkins. Eddie started racing when he was 16 years old. He rode Triumphs, Harley, PSA, Yamahas, Ducatis. Eddie rode flat track as well as road race. And he started racing in scrambles. He raced all the AMA events, well, it's the local club events. He was national number 78 and 66, and after a one-year break in his career, he came back with a 58 seat. Eddie raced until he was 33, at which time he turned tuner. His first rider was national number 96, Bill Schaefer, and he's here with us tonight. During this time, he tuned for Willie Crabb. The following year, he took a job with Taylor White Racing and tuned for Taylor White the fourth, Rodney Ferris, Dale Singleton. He then took Jimmy Felice, who won three nationals that year, and he also found time to tune for Steve Moorhead. To name a few of the races that came through his stables were Rodney Ferris, Kenny Kluvit, Will Davis, George Roeder, Chris Evans, Chris Hart, Henry Wilds, and now Ricky Marshall. He also helped more riders than any time will allow to mention. He's been involved in racing for 52 years, and each year is his last before retirement. Eddie's married Bernice and has a daughter, a son, and three grandchildren. I think we have the grandson. Could he get away?
No.
Okay, he's stationed over in the Army. They think that they're more important. Anyhow, all I can say is that Eddie has paid his dues. He has definitely completed the service. Eddie, we have a plaque here that says Master Tuner Award. Eddie Adkins, do a racer's reunion. It has a stopwatch and a set of micrometers, which are representative of his trade. The micrometers for the accuracy that he works with, the stopwatch for the speed, the time that it works.
More honor than anything I really deserve, but I really want to thank Eddie and his wife for doing this. This is the first one I've made. Too bad it's the last one, so he says. In order to do something like this, you got to have good people riding for you, and I've always had that. Certainly the rest of the people up here, they know exactly what I'm talking about. Come like your children, and they do you honor. This is what we get the reward, and we let them have the glory.